can't go to sleep. But the whole practice of meditation is for you to observe what's going on in your mind and your thinking. So, with that, I'm gonna go and feel free to go and grab some water now. Get yourself comfortable. Some blanket, maybe to cover over your knee. So that's what I like to do. So tonight we're going to go over, I will be guiding you through a mountain meditation, and I got this from Peluche. Actually, this is originated from Jon Kabat-Zinn's mountain meditations. So I am, okay, so we got that. So get yourself comfortable. And I'm going to go ahead and start. I had a couple people that was coming. Let me share this for one more and we're going to get started. Yeah. Okay. And start. Can you hear me okay? Let me know if you can still hear. I'm going to go and turn this up. Oops, that's on maximum. All right. So you can still hear me. That's important. Good. Oh, am I being paused? Okay, you can hear me. Okay. Nếu mà nghe được thì thầy thôi không sao, không biết. I don't know what's happened to the Facebook. But as long as you can hear me, that's important. So just sit. So get yourself comfortable. Good. So now get yourself comfortable and let's sit together. For those who are coming late, feel free just to join in right now. So right now, typically this is at sitting position. And you can sit on the chair if you cannot sit on the ground right now. Sit them up nice and tall. So right now we are just noticing your body at this moment, the actual body making contact, and just finding the stability and poise, upper your body balance over your hip and shoulders, and in a comfortable alert position. You can put your hand on your laps or your knee. For me, I like to put it like this. Or hanging on their own weight, like a heavy curtain, stable and relaxed. So actually sensing your body right now, just being aware of your feet. You can start on your left feet, moving up to your ankles, to your left calves, to your knee, to your thighs. Moving up to your pelvis area. Just being aware of your abdomen. Just being aware of your chest right now. Moving up to your upper body, through your left arms, shoulders, arm, elbow, hands. And just bring it back up to your throat, your face. Relaxing your face. And just being aware of your right side of your body now. Right arm, elbow, your hands, work your way down to your right hip, your right thighs, your knee, your calves, and your foot. So now when you're ready, just allow your eyes to close. Just bring in the awareness to your breath. Actual physical sensation, feeling each breath in as it comes in and goes out. Just letting the breath be just as it is without trying to change or regulate it in any way. Allowing it to flow easily and naturally with its own rhythm and pace. Knowing that you are breathing perfectly well right now, nothing for you to do. Allowing the body to be still and sitting with a sense of dignity, a sense of resolve, a sense of being complete, whole, in this very moment, with your posture reflecting the sense of wholeness. As you are sitting here, letting an image form in your mind, eyes, of the most magnificent or beautiful mountain you know or have seen or can imagine. Let it gradually come into greater focus, and even if it doesn't come as a visual image, allowing the sense of the mountain and feeling its overall shape, its lofty peaks or peaks high in the sky, the large base rooted in the bedrock of the earth crust, its deep or gentle sloping sides, noticing how massive it is, how solid, how unmoving, how beautiful, whether from afar or up close. Perhaps your mountain now has no peaks, blinking on top of the trees, reaching down to the base of rugged granite slides. There are many streams of waterfall cascading down the slope. There may be one peak or a series of peaks, or with meadows and high lakes. Observing it, noting its qualities, and when you feel ready, see if you can bring the mountain into your own body, sitting here, so that your body and the mountain in your minds, I become one as you sit here. You share the massiveness and the stillness of the majestic of the mountain. You become the mountain, grounded in the sitting posture. Your head become lofty peak, supported by the rest of the mountain. Your buttocks and legs are solid base, rooted to the cushion or the chair. Experiencing your body's sense of uplift from deep within your pelvis and spine. With each breath, as you continue sitting, becoming a little more breathing mountain, alive and vital, yet unwavering in your inner stillness, completely what you are, beyond words and thought, a centered, grounded, unmoving presence. As you sit here, becoming aware of the fact that is, as the sun travels across the sky, the light and shadows and colors are changing. Virtually moments by moment, in the mountain stillness and the surface teems with life, and activity. Streams, melting snow, waterfall, plant, wildlife. As the mountain sits, seeing and feeling how nights follow day, and day follows night. The bright warming sun, followed by the cool night sky, studded with stars, and the gradual dawning of a new day. Though it all, the mountain just sits, experiencing the change in each moment, constantly changing, yet always just being itself. It remains still as the seasons flow into one another, as the weather changes moment by moment and day by day. Calmness abiding all change. In summer, there's no snow on the mountain, except perhaps the very peak in the crags shielded from direct sunlight. In the fall, the mountain may wear a coat of brilliant fire colors. In winter, blanket of snow and ice. In any season, it may find itself at times enshrouded in the clouds or fog or petered by freezing rain. People may come to see the mountain and comment on how beautiful it is, or how it's not a good day to see the mountain. That is, too cloudy, or rainy, or foggy, or dark. None of this matters to the mountain, which remain at all times in its essential self. Clouds may come and clouds may go. Tourists may like it or not. The mountain magnificence and the beauty are not changing one bit by whether people see it or not. Seen or unseen, in sun or clouds, broiling or frigid, day or night. It just sits, being itself. At times, visited by violent storms, buffeted by snow and rain and winds, and unthinkable magnitude. Through it all, the mountain sits. Spring comes, trees, leaves out, flower bloom in the high meadow and slope. Birds sing in the trees once again. Streams overflow with the waters of melting snow. Through it all, the mountain continues to sit, unmoved by the weather, by what happens on its surface, by the world of appearances, remaining its essential self, through the seasons, the changing weather, the activity ebbing and flowing on its surface. In the same way, as we sit in meditation, we can learn to experience the mountain. We can learn to embody the same center, unwavering stillness and groundedness in the face of everything that changes in our own lives, over seconds, over hours, even years. In our lives and in our meditation practice, we experience constantly the changing nature of our mind and body of the outer world. We have our own periods of light and darkness, activity, inactivity, our own moments of colors, our own moments of darkness. It's true that we experience storms in varying intensity and violence in the outer world. And it's our own minds and bodies, buffered by high winds, by cold and rain. We endure periods of darkness and pain, as well as the moments of joy and uplift. Even our appearance changes constantly, experiencing a weather of its own. By becoming the mountain in our own meditation practice, we can link up in with this strength and stability and adopt them for our own. We can use its energies to support our own energy to encounter each moment with mindfulness and equanimity and clarity. It may help us to see that our thoughts and feelings, our preoccupations, or our emotional storm and crisis, even the thing that happened to us, are very much like the weather on the mountain. We tend to take it all personally, but its strongest characteristic is impersonal. The weather of our own lives is not to be ignored or denied. It is to be encountered, honored, felt, known for what is, and held in awareness. And in holding in this way, we come to know a deeper silence and stillness and wisdom. Mountains have this to teach us and much more if we can let it in. So, if you find you resonate in some way with the strength and stability of the mountain in your sitting, it may be helpful to use this from time to time. And you practice to remind of you that it meant to sit mindfully and resolve with wakefulness and stillness. So now, in the time that remain, continue to sustain this mountain meditating in your own, in the silence moment by moment until you hear the sound of the bell. Just merely observing the in and out of the breath. That's all, just being solid like a mountain. And just observing mind. Just being aware of your thoughts. As the monkey mind wanders, just bring it back to your breath. Sit here till you hear the bell ring. So now take a nice deep breath in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out, completely emptying all the air out. So now get a stretch our head, just being present with each movement and being aware of it. Up, stretch.
Down.
Up, stretch.
And down.
And two more. Can look right, turn the head, right, left, one, right, left, two, right, left, three, right, left, four, right, left, five, and one final tuck in your face, tuck in your chin, and stretch. So we're going to start lifting our right shoulder. One, two, three, four, five. So open your hands, close your hands, open your hands, close your hands, open your hands, close them. And then massage your face. Stretch your head 20 times. Now we massage your ears. Neck. Eyes. Place your right hand under your left armpit and vice versa, left over your right shoulder. Go up and down 10 times. And reverse. One hand on your chest, one on your back. Down the mid and below the belly. Now massage your back a little bit here. Here you can stay as long as you want. If it hurts more, if it's sore, you can stay a little longer. Really, there's no amount. So now from your hip down to your thighs, do this 10 times. And now gently removing your right foot if you set a lotus position like myself, half lotus. So massaging your knee and your ankles. Rubbing it and squeezing your toes. Put some pressure points on your foot, giving a really good massage and thanking it for the beautiful work that it does daily to hold up on your weight. And you can stretch the right leg out. Then repeat. feet on the left leg. And then the right toe, left toes, left foot, massage. Massaging your ankles. And you can stretch both legs out, reaching out three times. And then restore back here. And take some nice deep breath. Just connecting our energies right now. And thank you for those who are re-watching. May you have many blessings. Sending love and kindness from your heart for the merits. And back to Mother Gaia, the entire planet and its human race, all living beings, the small, seen and unseen, sending this beautiful love and energy throughout the universe and beyond. And thank you, Namaste, for joining in tonight. Thank you. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.